Welcome everyone to the presentation of a new exciting new solicitation that we have released on an NSF test bed with a network of programmable cloud laboratories, also known as NSF PCL test bed or the PCL solicitation. Today we'll give you a high level overview of the program, beginning with a little introduction to NSF and the TIP directorate. The presenters today are myself, Chaitan Baru, and my colleague, Alex Vadati. We are both from the TIP directorate. So this solicitation is about accelerating science by supporting autonomous laboratory ecosystems across the US. These laboratories would combine technological and human capacity to enable integration, testing, evaluation, validation, and translation of cutting-edge technology solutions in support of science and engineering research. The opportunity in this particular case is open to proposers from academia, from business and industry, and also nonprofits. Before we talk about that, just a few introductory slides about NSF, the National Science Foundation itself. The mission of NSF is to promote the progress of science, advance the national health, prosperity, and welfare of the nation, secure the national defense. NSF is in its 75th year this year. This was the original mission for NSF when it was formed 75 years ago, and it continues to be our mission. Within that, we have priorities that are current as of today. One is, of course, strengthening the established NSF that has been around, as we said, for 75 years, known for promoting, supporting basic research in science and engineering, which are investments that have helped expand the frontiers of our knowledge and discovery. So we want to continue to support that. That's one of the priorities for the agency as a whole. The other priority is to create opportunities and provide access for all Americans to all of these advances that are happening through the STEM disciplines, and also supporting workforce development, education, and so on, so that the entire population can participate in this. And the third priority is accelerating transfer of these research results into technological solutions and innovation that have impact on society. Within that sits the TIP Directorate, Technology, Innovation, and Partnerships. We are about 3 years old. NSF is 75 years old. And the core reason for TIP is to advance US competitiveness and societal impact by nurturing partnerships that drive and accelerate the creation of regional innovation ecosystems for economic growth, technology translation and development, and workforce development. And as you'll see in this solicitation, we are certainly touching on all of those, but especially on the tech translation and workforce development aspects. You can think of the role that TIP plays in this full spectrum, from laboratory-based foundational research to societal impact, as helping along multiple steps along the way, right? So everything from use-inspired research. So you go from foundational research to saying, okay, if there's a particular kinds of problems that I want to solve, you know, what's the research I need for that? Proofs of concept that take that research further down the line towards a solution, prototype development, and product solution development. Typically, we think of one side, which is the foundational research being funded with public funds, and the other side, which is creation of companies and scaling companies to large scale through private funds, venture capital, and so on. And there is a need to bridge that gap between the two ends. Okay. And one of the things you'll also see in the PCL solicitation is we are trying to bridge, as we said, it's about translation, it's about bringing latest technologies towards supporting discovery and innovation. So we're trying to bridge that gap between technology and innovation there. The way we got started off in this particular area was NSF ran, the TIP director ran a couple of workshops on this topic of programmable cloud laboratories. One was hosted at Carnegie Mellon University. The other one was hosted at North Carolina State University, but participants came from everywhere. And basically the kind of things that were investigated in these workshops were, you know, how do you accelerate laboratory science and discovery, especially using AI in the loop to make things go faster? How can you support programmable experiments? That is a lab that is more generally designed that can support a variety of experiments, not just one hard-coded set of things that you could do, which requires flexible and programmable interfaces. And how could you provide remote access so that equipment doesn't have to be at your place? In other words, not every campus or every industry may need to have the equipment owned by them. They could use something essentially that's in the cloud. So you can think of this as cloud-based access, which is remote access to equipment that may be pretty expensive and not everyone might be able to acquire those. And then how do you facilitate collaboration among these kinds of labs that get set up so that there are common standards for metadata, data, how AI is used, AI standards, how experiments are validated, so that the experiments done in these kind of facilities can be trusted, results can be shared, and people know that they can reproduce what somebody else has done. So our goal with this solicitation is to think about a network of such labs that we could create across the country, which are all connected together basically through a common substrate, you can think of it, of standards. The standards in metadata, standards in data, standards in the AI tools, and the AI algorithms and models that might be used. So that gives you a high level sort of view of where we are coming from on this PCL solicitation. I'm going to hand it off to my colleague Alex, who's going to talk to you more about the details of this solicitation itself. So Alex, on to you.
Thank you, Chaitan. Appreciate it. I'm Alex Vadati, Program Director in the TIP Directorate. So I'll continue this presentation. So first, I'd like to give you a brief overview of what are the potential science drivers for this program and how we hope to accelerate scientific advancement. So each of these proposals for the solicitation, we expect to have a clear description of one or more science drivers for each PCL node. So for example, science drivers could be related to advanced materials, material science, or material synthesis and characterization. Another good example of a science driver for this solicitation is biotechnology. For example, high throughput characterization services for the bioeconomy supply chain. Next slide, please. Thank you. In terms of data and AI capabilities, we want each node and each proposer to have demonstrated expertise in data management and curation and state-of-the-art AI models and methods. Also, creation of AI models to support efficient and effective use of the node and testbed would be beneficial. And also use of AI for coordination across nodes would add value to your proposals. We also want AI to be closely integrated with lab experiments in these nodes. So for example, in the pre-experiment stage, we want AI to be used to assist in designing optimal experimental setups or to simulate the outcome of experiments. So we can reduce the number of physical experiments that are needed and make the experiments more efficient. Now at the experimental stage, for example, you could use AI to monitor real-time data through various sensors and imaging tools that you have integrated with the lab instruments. And you can control the experimental conditions also autonomously and make real-time adjustments on the fly to your experiments. So that's another good example of using AI at the experimental stage. And finally, post-experiment, Of course, AI, as an example, can be used to recommend follow-up experiments or accelerate your data analysis and visualization. Now, what are some usage models of these nodes and the test bed? So we envision to have power users, for example, high throughput users, first-time automated lab users, prototyping users, industry users, educational and research users. So we envision a wide range of users for these PCL nodes. In terms of your patients that have pre-existing instrument facilities are eligible to apply to the program to be a node. Also, proposals must include at least one co-PI with relevant expertise in data management and AI to support the activities that are in the proposal. Each of these PCL nodes will be funded up to $5 million per year for 4 years. And so your total budget should not exceed $20 million per PCL node. With respect to multi-institutional proposals for projects that involve collaboration among multiple institutions, the proposal should come from a single lead institution, with funding for the other participating institutions made through subawards. Proposals that are submitted as separate proposals to the NSF as collaborative proposals, as described under this specific section of PAPG that we have referenced here, those proposals will be returned without review. Now, what type of organizations can apply for this opportunity? Institutions of higher education, of course, IHEs, 2 and 4 year institutions, including community colleges that you know, that are accredited and have campus located in the US and are acting on behalf of their faculty members. For-profit organizations are also eligible to apply. These can be US-based commercial organizations, including small businesses with strong capabilities in scientific or engineering research or education, and a passion for innovation. And finally, nonprofit, non-academic organizations are also eligible to apply. For example, independent museums, observatories, research labs, professional societies, community organizations, and similar organizations that are located in the US and are directly associated with educational or research activities, or that bring relevant expertise and perspectives. Now, in terms of the review criteria, so the standard NSF review criteria, of course, applies here, both intellectual merit and broader impacts. So intellectual merit encompasses the potential to advance knowledge, and broader impacts, they encompass potential benefit to society and contribution to achievement of a specific and desired societal outcomes. Also, this program has its own additional review criteria, which I'm going to talk about on the next slide. So what are the solicitation specific criteria for this program? So first, you need to have clear science drivers and elaborate what science drivers will help transform the science and engineering areas in your PCL node. Secondly, you want to have data and AI capabilities and expertise represented for each PCL node. The third one is node capabilities, so including an instrument or inventory table, node expertise, partnerships, access control, and those kinds of details in your proposals. The fourth one is cross-node collaboration, so how you can potentially collaborate across a range of different areas, such as metadata, data and data sharing standards, AI models with other nodes. And then training and education is the next one. So in areas that are represented by science drivers, you know how you can contribute to training and education. And the next one is new users and user communities that you can bring to the table to use these PCL test beds, and especially for the first time. And then the last ones, I'm not going to read all the details because you can find all of this in the solicitation, but also you need to have clear metrics defined to evaluate the PCL node usage and user satisfaction. You need to have a detailed management plan and plan for post-award continued operation of the test bed. And finally, in terms of budget preparation, you need to cover specific aspects, for example, node operations, resources, science driver support, and data and AI support and onboarding of users, for example. That's just a few examples. So please find all the details in the solicitation and make sure you pay close attention to the solicitation specific criteria for this program. Also, please make sure you review the latest version of NSF's Proposal and Award Policies and Procedures Guide, or PAPG. We put a link here for you. And also, please review the important information on this page that we have linked below that, on additional guidance on NSF's priorities and executive order implementation. Also, if you are not able to or not interested in submitting a proposal for this opportunity, you can always be a reviewer. You can volunteer to be a reviewer for the NSF PCL Testbed program. If you are interested in serving as a reviewer and you believe you have the right expertise and experience to serve as a reviewer, please email us at pcl-testbed@nsf.gov with your name, organization, and information on your areas of expertise, and we'll get in touch with you. Now, in terms of the timeline, the solicitation is released in early August, and we expect to have a webinar with live Q&A later in August, and then we expect to publish the FAQs shortly after. And we'll have office hours scheduled in August and September, and we will publish those details and the times and dates of those office hours as soon as we finalize the dates. We expect this solicitation to close sometime in November, and after that, we expect to start the proposal review process. And finally, if you have any questions about this program, please always feel free to email us .gov, and we have posted the email addresses for research.gov helpdesk and grants.gov contact center if you need support with those platforms. Thank you, Chaitan.
Thanks, Alex. With that, that concludes the presentation about this program. Feel free to contact us as shown here. Thank you.